great strides in the global fight against COVID-19. Now moving on, there was drama at All Saints Cathedral today as relatives fought for the remains of deceased lawyer Bob Kasango. Now this happened after the service as relatives failed to agree on where to bury the deceased lawyer. Now reporter Rachel Nachiwala followed this story and brings us this report.
Bob Kasango, 46, died of heart failure at Luzira Prison, where he has been incarcerated for the last 3 years. The family today held a requiem service at All Saints Church in Kampala, from where hell broke loose. As the service ended, Kasango's relatives from the mother and father's side, who had been patiently waiting outside the church, gathered near the A-plus van. When the pallbearers tried to put the casket in the van, the relatives grabbed it and carried it towards a waiting truck. Was, however, chaos as relatives from Kasango's wife's side faced off with their colleagues from the lawyer's parents. Led by his wife, Nice Bintarabeho Kasango, and eldest son, Samora Paul Kasango, the relatives tried to stop the other side from taking the casket, but it was too late as they were overpowered and the casket loaded onto a waiting truck that drove off at a terrific speed. Speaking to journalists, the relatives from Kasango's parents' side said they could not allow him to be buried at the wife's ancestral grounds. Some of the deceased siblings said he was born Bob Okello but got the name Kasango from one of his uncles.
No person who has Bob Kasango has never been a Mtoro. Has never been a Mtoro. He's a Jap, he has a home, he has father.
How can we marry him at his in-laws? We have to take him back to his ancestral home. We can't marry him at his in-laws. That is being unfair. We can't marry Bob at his in-laws. We have to take Bob back to Toronto.
The family members said Kasango's body will be laid to rest at Wekusi Village, Karandi Parish, Kirewa Sub-County Interior District, contrary to earlier plans of burying him in Fort Portal later on Thursday. Meanwhile, those who had taken the body were intercepted in Namgongo by security operatives. The 46-year-old lawyer died at Luzira Prison on Saturday evening. At the time of his demise, Kasango was serving a 16-year imprisonment after he was convicted of conspiring to forge a court order, a certificate of taxation, and a certificate of costs directing the Attorney General to pay his law firm 15.4 billion shillings. The money in question had been meant to pay pension and gratuity of more than 6,340 pensioners between 2011 and 2012. Kasango was jointly sentenced with former public service top officials Jimmy Lwamafa, who was sentenced to 9 years, Christopher Obey, who was sentenced to 14 years, and Stephen Chiwanuka Konsa, who was sentenced to 9 years. I am Rachel Nachiwala, reporting for the news in Kampala.